जय हिंद ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम डॉक्टर राहुल बंसल फ्रॉम अजय कुमार गर्ग इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। सो दिस वन इज द नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस KEC 301। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। सो इन दिस वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स, राइट? सो ए फेमस कोटेज दैट इज लाइक गिवन बाय लाइक रिचर्ड फेमन, दैट इज वी कैन सेफली से दैट nobody understand the quantum mechanics according to this Richard Feynman, who got the Nobel Prize in 1965. So before we start into the mathematics of this quantum mechanics, there are three basic principles that are to be considered. So first is the principle of energy quanta, next is the wave particle duality principle, next is the uncertainty principle. Okay, so what is actually the energy quanta is? So in one experiment, certain scientists has demonstrated that there is an inconsistency between the experimental result and the classical theory of light. That is called as the photoelectric effect, which was given by Einstein in 1905. So what does it says? It says that whenever we incident a monochromatic light on the material, okay, so it should have the if it is having the wave this function, right, that is greater than that of the material, then it can detach the electron from the material. Okay, so if at all we incident the monochromatic light on the surface of the material, then under certain condition the electron are emitted from the surface. So this was said by this theory, and according to the this classical physics, if we see if the incident light is large enough, or you can say it is having the higher work function than that of the material, then the electron will be emitted from the surface, which is independent of the frequency, right? So it was like demonstrated in 1905. Next is, this result will not be like seen, or you can say observed. The observed effect is that the incident intensity and the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron will vary linearly with the frequency, okay, with the limited frequency, with the limiting frequency of, like, if you say it's V, okay, so below which there is no photoelectron will be produced, as you can see from this diagram also. Okay, if at all the electron, if at all the incident light is having the below the frequency of like V, then it will not emit the electron. So this was according to the classical physics. Okay, next is the emission and the absorption and the absorption. So if the consider a silicon material, if we consider this silicon material, it consists of like four electron in the outermost shell, as you can see, first, second, third and fourth. Okay, so after gaining the energy, this four electron will be emitting from its surface, silicon surface. Okay, so this is called as like emission. Okay, this electron will be gaining the energy and they will be moving from the valence band towards the conduction band. That is, conduction band is having the higher energy level. If we consider this upper band as like valence band, okay, upper level of this lower energy band, which is called as the valence band, and higher level of this upper energy band, that is conduction band. Okay, so if I consider this as silicon, then after gaining this energy, after excitation, this electron will be moving from this valence band towards the conduction band. Okay, so that they will contribute towards the conductivity. right? So this is only possible whenever the incident light is having the higher frequency, or you can say higher frequency that are required to detach this from the silicon material, right? So if at all incident light is varied with a constant frequency, then the rate of photoelectron emission will be changes. Okay, but the maximum kinetic energy remains same. So this is the postulate that can be drawn. Okay, so whenever it lose the energy from like higher energy level towards the lower energy level, then it will move back from this high energy level towards the lower energy level. Okay, it will emit the energy in the form of heat and light, heat or light. So this is the basic phenomena of emission and absorption. This, the movement of the molecule, movement of the electron from this high energy level towards the lower energy level is called as the absorption. Okay, it will, the electron will be absorbed by the hole which was created at the valence band, right? So this is, this process is called as the absorption, right? Next is, this Planck postulated that the energy, the thermal radiation that is emitted from a heated surface is in the form of discrete packet energy, which he called it as quanta. Right, which is he called this as quanta, right? And the energy of this quanta is given by E is equal to h nu. Where this h is called as a Planck constant. Its value is 6.626 into 10 to the minus 34 joule second. And this mu, this nu is called as frequency of the radiation, right? So this nu is frequency of the radiation, right? And mathematically it is given by C upon lambda, okay, where this C is called as the velocity of light. Its value is equal to C is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and lambda is equal to wavelength of light or beam, radiation beam, you can say, right? So this was postulated by Planck. The concept of quanta was postulated by Planck after a certain experiment. Then Einstein in 1905 interpreted the photoelectric result by suggesting that the energy in the light wave is also contained in the discrete packet, or you can say bundles also. So this was postulated by photoelectric effect by Einstein in 1905, and the particle-like packet of energy is called as photon. So these were named as photon, right? And energy is also, the energy of the photon is also given by this relation, that is E is equal to h nu, which is equal to h multiplied by frequency, hc upon lambda, which is equal to hc upon lambda, right? So what we can postulate from this, we can say that the photon with the sufficient energy can knock a electron from its surface of the material. And the minimum energy which is required to remove the electron is called as the work function, according to the classical physics. So this work function of the material, if it is greater, then electron will not be like detached from the material. If at all work function of the material is greater, then this incident light. If at all incident light work function is greater, then it will detach the electron from the material. Okay, and the excess of the photon energy goes into the kinetic energy of the photoelectron. Okay, so this was again the next postulate that can be drawn. The maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron was like given by this half mv square, right? So which can be like given as half mv square, which is equal to the difference between the this discrete energy, that is h nu minus h nu naught, right? Where this h nu is called as incident photon energy and h nu naught is the minimum energy that is required to detach the electron from the surface of the material, and which is also called as the work function, right? So there is one numerical which is like very crucial for your like examination purpose, for your UPTU examination purpose, AKTU examination purpose. That is, if we are given like, we have to calculate the photon energy of the particular wavelength, right? And we are given the wavelength, that is 0.708 into 10 square minus 8 centimeter. So we are given like wavelength, that is lambda. Okay, we have to calculate the value of corresponding photon energy. So how to proceed for this type of questions? So basically we have the basic mathematical relation, that is E is equal to h nu, as we have like discussed, right, which is equal to hc upon lambda. So we are having the value of c, that is 3 into 10 square 8 meter per second. We have the value of this h, 6.626 into 10 square minus 34 joule second. And in the numerical itself, it is given like lambda is given to us. Okay. So we have to compute the value of E. So E is equal to H C upon lambda, which is equal to 2.81 into 10 square minus 15 joule. In many exam, question is asked in the electron volt. So we have to convert this joule into the electron volt. So if you want to convert this joule into the electron volt, what you have to do is we have to divide this energy in the joule by 1.6 into 10 square minus 19, right, which is the charge on the electron, right? So energy in electron volt will be equal to 2.8 into 10 square minus 15 divided by 1.6 into 10 square minus 19. Which is equal to 1.75 into 10 to the 4 electron volt, right? So this is how we can like solve this type of simple questions in the exam also. Now next is uncertainty principle, or you can say Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So it was like given in 1927. Okay, so what does it say? It says that the relation between the variables, including the position and the momentum and the energy and the time. Basically, it says that we cannot find the position and velocity of any of the like a particle of, or you can say electron, right, at the same instant of time. This is in accordance with the uncertainty principle. So first statement, if I want to define, is it is impossible to simultaneously describe the absolute accuracy of the position and the momentum of the particle. If the uncertainty of the momentum is given by like delta p, and the uncertainty in the position is given by delta x, right? So according to this principle, mathematically we can define this principle as this delta p into delta x should be greater than h dash, right? Where this h dash has the value of h upon 2 pi. H value you already know, as we have already discussed, that is 6.626 into 10 to the minus 34 joule second, and divided by 2 pi, right? Similarly, in terms of the uncertainty in the energy and the uncertainty in the time, if you multiply these two terms, it should be greater than h dash, which is the second postulate of the uncertainty principle, right? So the second statement, if I want to conclude from the uncertainty principle, that is, it is impossible to simultaneously describe the absolute accuracy of the energy of the particle and the instant of time of the particle, right? So it is mathematically described by this mathematical relation, right? So in the next video lecture we will be like discussing about the EK diagrams and its applications. Okay, so thank you all of you for your patience. Thank you.